Hi, I'm Morten Nissen, and I would like to present a new viewer called ShowCFD, which is a way to display results from WAsP CFD. And if you have a later version of WAsP CFD installed, then you know that you can replace the normal solution of the flow by a CFD solution. And you can also, then all the results are different when you have this solver. And also, for instance, the resource grids, then you have noticed that there will be more layers. For instance, there's a flow inclination and a turbulence intensity layer. And the way that it works is that you order the results from a high performance computer cluster, and then you import it back to the local PC. If you're unfamiliar with WAsP CFD, then you can go here to wasp.dk, and that is a home server, and then click on this item, and then it will just explain about WAsP CFD here. Now, the CFD results are not stored directly in the WAsP workspace, but in a subfolder here. Here I have a WAsP workspace here, and then here's a subfolder, and then you have results files for each 2x2 kilometer, or the tiles where you have ordered these more detailed calculations. And if you you can actually open it, and then you can see that it contains a lot of files for a lot of wind directions and for different heights, and then there's an elevation grid, and there's also a WAsP contour map inside here. This is the user interface of ShowCFD, and if you click File here, then you can load the results files and then display different fields, turbulence intensities, wind speed, and some of them are directly from the files, other are calculated. For instance, this wind shear exponent, that is actually calculated from two heights, one below and above the height of interest, and then you fit a power law. And you can define exactly how you define these two heights here over to the right. And then you can change the wind direction and observe how the solution changes, and the height can also be changed. And instead of showing all the fields, then you can choose just to show one of them. Then it becomes more clear, perhaps. And you can zoom in. Here is the one of the results. This is the wind results, and the wind is coming from this direction here. You can also choose to display the wind direction here, and especially if you go closer to the terrain, then you can see that it's modified by the topography. And then you can select to show a vertical wind profile here in this transect plot. If you go click here, maybe behind it, now I change the reference point here. I can do that by either by clicking here or in the main view here, or I can do it accurately by typing in the coordinates here. The transects that can be aligned according to the wind direction, either along the wind or across the winds. And if you think that it's too small, then you can increase the aspect ratio here. And then when you move the cursor over here, then at the status line at the bottom, then you can see that what the values are in the field. I should also say a fast way to change the wind direction is simply by clicking the mouse and hold it, and then swipe across it, then it should find the wind direction here. And also here this reference point where that was changed by clicking on the map. Now you can also see the results here in tables like this, one for the vertical profile and one for the horizontal program. And if you click and then press Ctrl C on the keyboard, then you will copy the results to the Windows clipboard, and then you can paste it into something like Excel. And for the graphics, then you press Ctrl and then click somewhere on the map, then it's also copied as a graphics to the to the Windows clipboard. Or you can go here to File and then you say Copy and then do the same thing the same way. Maybe I forgot to say about the color scale here. If you think that you want to see something more clearly, then you can right click here on the color scale, and then there's a small dialog where you can, instead of having automatic color rates, then you can define what you want it to be. I think maybe that's enough for you to get started with this.